Good afternoon. I am Bharat Sapkota. Currently, I am working in Greenwell Solar. Here, I am going to explain about the development of charging infrastructure in Nepal. Charging infrastructure is a combination of power grid, charger module, and also the operation of the system. Charger can be classified into two types. One is onboard charger and next is offboard charger. Onboard charger supports up to 32 amp single phase electricity. Most of the cars are equipped with onboard charger, and BYD have onboard charger that support up to 42 kilowatt AC, and it supports three phase. Rest of all the chargers support single phase as a input, and off-board charger are DC chargers. And we are going to explain and about these off-board chargers, because charging stations are made up of off-board chargers. Different type of here I have mentioned different type of DC chargers. In the beginning, CHAdeMO was the DC charger, and later CHAdeMO become obsolete, and combined charging system and GBT are becoming more popular in our country. Here I am showing some of our works that we have done in the past time. We have installed type 2 AC charger in Lumini Development Trust. This was the first charger that was installed in that place. And we have installed another charger in Kuvelar store. That is on the Prithivi Highway and at Tonau. And the next one is at Ministry of Forest, Environment and Soil Conservation. That is in Kandagi province. And these are the fast charging standard used in Nepal. CHAdeMO, I already said that CHAdeMO was in practice in the past time, and Kia Soul EV may be the only electric vehicle that support CHAdeMO in case of our country. And CCS2 is another, and GBT. Here I'm going to explain the technical aspect. NEA is the only electricity provider in our country. Being only electricity provider, NEA must, all of the project are fully dependent on NEA, because we cannot generate electricity. We can only borrow electricity from NEA, and that is used to charge the vehicles or that is used to complete our project. The other thing is EV charger, type of EV charger and compatibility. There are different type of EV chargers. The charging protocol that is used. I already told that some are CHAdeMO, some are CCS, and some are GBT. And one charging standard is not compatible to other vehicle. Some vehicle are equipped with CCS charging protocol and some with GBT, and because of those technical people face some problem due to these technical standards. And other is the team of technical expert. There are very less people who are well trained for the installation, operation, and even designing of the charging station. And the next one is operation and maintenance. The operation and maintenance is not the bigger issue in this time, but in the future, operation and maintenance will be the big issue, because I already told that there are very less technical experts. This is because electric vehicle are evolving in our country with very less time, and so that operation and maintenance is not very good in our case. And the next one is networking for the user convenience. If all the vehicles should be connected in the network, maybe within the form of mobile application or some other form, so that individual vehicle user can be informed with that with the status of the charging station, and he can decide whether to charge in that station or select the next charging destination. And these are to be developed in case of our country. And challenges, there are some challenges we have faced during the installation of the charging station, and some are predicted with our experience. The major challenge we faced from the NES side is quality of the grid voltage and consistency of power supply from the national grid. When we choose to reduce the cost of installation of the system and cost of the project, then we should eliminate the installation of transformer and some distribution network. In that point, NEA will provide 400 volt electricity that is provided to other factories and other customer also. Definitely, charging station need very consistent and consistent power, but sometimes so we cannot get consistent and quality power. In that case, we have to offset with the quality, and because of that, some EV charging station are facing some problem of charging at very low speed as compared to the estimated time. And if we choose the quality grid, then we need to install additional transformer and distribution line that will increase the cost. And if cost is increased, I'm talking from the private sector side, and if cost is increased, and that will impact the project cost, and the project, if project cost is increased, then that the direct impact will be on return on investment. And the next challenge is diverse charging standard. As I already mentioned, DIGO is following GBT standard, and they have installed various GBT type charging station, and they are going to install the same in other places too. And the vehicle that are imported by DIGO can support that charging, but other vehicles such as Kia, Niro, Hyundai, MG, BYD, Tata, and other electric vehicles that are manufactured and imported from India, they will not support GBT. They will only support CCS. And in that case, GBT will not be benefited by the charging station that supports CCS. But most of the car companies, branded car companies, they will not be benefited by the charging station that are installed from DIGO. And Chademo was installed by Kia. Chademo was followed by Kia Soul. But now Kia Soul, maybe Chademo will not be installed in other electric cars. But I think GBT and CCS will be two type of charging standard. And there will not be benefit from each other, and that will be the challenge for in the coming future, because we are not following the single charging standard. Even Nepal is very small country, but we are not following this. And the next challenge is availability of well-trained human resources for the installation, maintenance, and even in operation. If we go to the smart operation system such as networking and development of mobile application in all the sectors, in private sector, and we should connect this networking to private sector, to the charging station that are maintained by even public sector and even private sector. If we do not do this, then there will be lots of chaos, so that we'll face lots of problem. And the next problem is availability of well-trained human resources, because I think only EV importers are giving the training of electric vehicle. Maintenance diagnosis of electric vehicle, but nobody is focused in the training of electric vehicle charging station, charger. I think the people have very less knowledge when compared to the electric vehicles, very less knowledge of charging station when compared to the knowledge of electric vehicles. So that in the future, there will be some problem due to that. And the next challenge is cost of the project versus return on investment. I have heard that NEA is going to charge additional, NEA is given permission to charge additional 20% of the electricity cost to the customer by charging station owner. But I think the return on investment will be very long time, or the investor will not get any profit with that margin, because if we consider electric vehicle charging station as a business, then investment is far, far more higher when compared to the profit. And the needs. As NEA is the only provider of electricity, they should be clear about their roles and responsibilities. Some roles and responsibilities are consistent tariff rate and subsidy. Sometimes the customer needs subsidy because even in today's case, we have installed some charging station in some places, but there are some charging station where the electric vehicle user never approach the charging station because the vehicle user never reached to their charging station, but the charging station owner is paying the bill of electricity, the minimum rate of electricity, even they are not using that charging station. And I think sometimes people need subsidy in those cases. And NEA also need to collect the data of whether the charging station is necessary or not. There are lots of people, they need to install charging station and they need to get the subsidy from NEA. But there are some location where charging station could be mandatory, but the proper data collection will help whether to install the charging station in that place or not. And the next one is the implementation of vehicle to grid. Vehicle to grid is for efficiency, stability, and reliability of national grid, power grid. And this concept actually helps to stabilize the grid when there is too much load. And this concept helps to charge the vehicle when there is surplus electricity in power grid side. But NEA should have the policy as early as possible to implement. This is not mandatory, but this is the very good option if NEA want to coordinate with private sector to provide the electricity for the charging station. And this will also help to stabilize the NEA power grid, stabilize the voltage of the power grid. In this case, the energy from the vehicle will be fed to the grid when grid voltage is unstable or grid voltage tends to reduce. And the next need is to installation and operation of charger by EV importers or sellers. There are lots of dealers of the importer. There are maybe all the electric vehicle importer, all the vehicle importer have importer have their dealer in major cities of Nepal. If they tend to install the charging station in their service center, then they can easily install, and the installation cost, even the project cost, will be reduced because they already have the infrastructure. They do not need to add any infrastructure. They only need to add the charging station and infrastructure that is related to power grid. And in that case, the operation and maintenance will be even easier when compared to other third parties who are willing to do the business of charging station. In this case, if EV importers are focused to install the charging station in their service center, then that will be far more easier to promote the electric vehicles, and even the operation and maintenance of the charging station will be more easier. And I already told that networking of all charging station is very much mandatory, because if we do not do this, there will be very chaotic in the coming future. Because if we do not go to the networking, then even user do not have any idea how to charge the vehicle, and even the charging station owner will not have the idea when the customer will come and they will occupy their charging station. Charging station should be occupied for more than half hour to more than half hour. In that case, the networking is mandatory. I think this is very much important for the smooth operation of the charging station. Thank you.